Good morning, students. Welcome back to the last session of chapter number 2, Working in Windows 10. Students, in the last session, we learned about taskbar. In this session, we will learn about customizing the Windows environment. Students, this session is very interesting. So, let's start.
Subject Computer, Standard 6, Chapter 2, Working in Windows 10, Session 3. Customizing the Windows environment. Students, when working with Windows, we can customize the appearance and functionality of the computer according to your preferences. Some of the customization options include customizing the start menu, changing the desktop background, pinning and unpinning programs from the taskbar. Students, let's understand customizing the start menu. The start menu in Windows 7 was a narrow column, and in Windows 8 it was replaced with the start screen, which was a large full screen menu as shown in the given picture. In Windows 10, the left part of the start menu is similar to that in Windows 7, but it has been extended on the right to include tiles. We can click and drag tiles to rearrange them according to our preference. Students, next we will do some operations that can be done on the tiles. First, we'll do resizing tiles.
Students, let's see how to resize a tile. For that, go to the start button, click on it. Now you can see there are many tiles given. I am choosing one tile, right click on that tile. Now you can see here resize option is given. There are four sizes given: small, medium, wide and large. You can choose the desired size, like I am selecting small. So it will show you in small size. Now again I am clicking on resize, medium. It will show you medium tile. Then again you can go to resize, click on wide. It will show you in wide size. Again for large size, click on the large. It will show you large size. Okay, children.
Students, next we will do pinning a tile.
Students, let's see how to pin a tile. For that, go to the start button. Then here you have all apps options, or you can see here all apps are given. Now you have to choose any one app, like I am selecting messaging. Okay, then right click on messaging and you can see pin to start option is given. Click on it, pin to start. Now you will notice that the app appears on a tile on the right side of the start menu. Okay, children.
Students, let's do unpinning a tile.
Students, as we learned how to pin a tile, now if you want to unpin that tile, what to do? Go to the start button. Now you can see messaging tile that we already have pinned in start menu. Okay, now for unpinning this tile, right click on it. Unpin from start option is given. Click on it. Now you can see the tile gets removed from the start menu. Got it, children?
Students, as we learned how to pin and unpin from the start menu. Okay, now we will learn pinning and unpinning from the taskbar.
Students, we can quickly access programs by pinning them on the taskbar. Let me show you how to pin a program to the taskbar. First of all, click on the Start button. Here you can see all apps are given. Okay, now choose any one application. Like I am selecting calendar. Right click on the calendar, go to the More option and choose Pin to Taskbar option. As you can see here, calendar icon is on the taskbar. Now, students, to unpin this calendar, right click on the calendar icon and here it is given Unpin from Taskbar option. Click on it and you can see that calendar icon will disappear from the taskbar. Got it, children? Changing the desktop background. Students, the picture or pattern that appears as the background of a desktop is called the wallpaper. Just as you like to change the picture displayed on the walls of a room from time to time, you can also change the wallpaper on the desktop. You can choose to have a solid color or a picture in the background. The picture could be your own picture or a picture from Windows Gallery. Now, students, let's do changing of the desktop background. Students, let me show you how to change the wallpaper or desktop background. Students, right click anywhere on the blank area of the desktop. Like here, right click on it. Then you can see the last option, that is personalize option. Click on it and you can see the personalization settings window here. Now click on the background option. Here in the background option, there are three options given: picture, solid color and slideshow. First of all, let's see solid color. In the solid color, you have to choose any color of your choice. Like I'm selecting purple shadow. Click on purple shadow and minimize the program. So students, here you can see the color chosen by you is set as the desktop background color. Okay, children? Students, let's see second option of the background, that is picture. Click on the drop-down list of the background, select picture option. Okay, children? Now, you can choose any picture from the given available pictures. Like I am selecting the last picture. Okay, you can also choose browse button and select any picture from your computer. As I have selected the last picture, you can see that picture is set as desktop background. Got it, children? Now, you can click and choose a suitable option from the Choose a Fit drop-down menu. Okay, this will decide the manner in which the picture will be displayed on the desktop. You can choose one of these options: Fill, Fit, Stretch, Tile, Center and Span. Okay, children, are you getting? Students, let's see third option of background, that is slideshow. Choose slideshow option in the background drop down list to have series of pictures in the background that keep changing at a fixed interval. Students, you can also click on browse button and choose the folder that has the pictures to be included in the slideshow. Students, you can also create folder of your own pictures. Now, specify the time after which
You want the picture to change by choosing a value from the Change Picture Every drop-down list. Here it is given different timings. Okay, children. Now, in the last, click and choose a suitable option from the Choose a Feed drop-down menu. This will decide how the pictures will be displayed. Okay, children. Now, students, you can also give it a try on your computer system.
Students, this session brings us to end of the chapter. I hope you all must have understood it well. Students, I request you all to practice at your home, revise all the sessions, read this chapter, and complete your worksheet.
All my dear students, stay home, stay safe, and let's stop COVID-19 together. Thank you.